As I have mentioned earlier, in this course we will learn how to develop Java applications using the MongoDB database, which is an open source document oriented database recognized as rising star in the NoSQL world. We will focus on the applications development, however we will at first gather all the resources to connect to the MongoDB and add a quick introduction to the world of NoSQL database. We will cover the following topics in the first chapter, in more detail. The first, in installing MongoDB and the client tools. The second, using MongoDB shell. Here is the PowerPoint of the first chapter. Before we diving into this PowerPoint, we should know that NoSQL is a generic term used to refer to any data store that doesn't follow the traditional relational database management systems or DBMS. That doesn't follow this traditional RDBMS model. The database or the data is non-traditional. And is in generally doesn't use SQL as a query language. Most of the databases that are categorized as NoSQL focus on availability and scalability in spite of consistency. All databases that fall into this category has some categories in common. The first, storing data in many formats. Almost all the databases fall in relational database management system are based on the storage of rows and tables. On the other hand, in the world of NoSQL, can use different formats such as document stores, graph tables, and key value store. Joinless NoSQL databases are able to extract your data using simple document-oriented interfaces without using SQL joins. Schemeless data representation means the characteristic of NoSQL implementations is that they are based on schemeless data representations. The advantage of this approach is that you don't need to define data structure beforehand, which can thus change over time. Ability to work with many machines. The most NoSQL systems by use ability to store your database on multiple machines while maintaining high performance speed. At first glance, these qualities seem vital in practice. However, for many applications, they are incompatible with the availability and the performance in very large environments. Let's suppose you have an online e-book store and you want to display how many of each book you have in your inventory. Each time a user in the process of buying a book, you need to lock part of the database until they finished. So that every visitor from the world will see the exact inventory numbers that works just fine for a small homemade site, not for large website like Amazon.com. For this reason, when we talk about NoSQL database, or generally if you are designing a distributed systems, we might have to have a look behind the traditional ACID properties. Most all database developers and administrators know the ACID acronym. It says that the database transaction should be atomicity. Everything in transaction either succeed or rolled back. Consistency, every transaction must leave the database in consistent state. Isolation, each transaction that is running can't interface with other transaction. Durability means the completed transaction gets persistence even after application restart.